So full stack development right now is the hottest trend in the market. What we used to see is that there were a specific set of techies who used to attend back-end, front-end, middleware, APIs kind of a work. But thanks to the full stack development and the set of tools, what has started happening is that now an individual can basically create a whole web application end-to-end without any dependency. Tools have become easier, programming languages are smarter now, the compilers, the debuggers, the IDEs are very smarter. So end of day, what has started happening is that you do a lot less work to achieve a lot more. And now it is much more smarter to basically be a full stack engineer rather than just taking part of the whole project. What enables is that you have more control over what you do, you learn more, you are able to implement things end to end because you know the application as a whole. 10 years earlier than this, what you used to do is you were either a database guy or you were a great front end engineer or you were a person who would only work with the middlewares of the system. But now with full stack, you know the application end to end, you understand it and you can build it at a much shorter time in a much better way. That's full stack development for you. So of course companies have option between only front-end, only back-end and a full-stack engineer. But as a company, we only prefer having full-stack engineers for many reasons. One is of course the cost part, because the same resource can be used across multiple projects, across multiple domains and in multiple modules. So I need not think through saying that, hey, is Mr. X available? Can he take that part of the project? I am very much convenient that he can take anything. So the cost is definitely a big advantage. But more importantly, I feel that full stack engineers, because of the genesis of how full stack is being developed, they know systems end to end and they understand things very well. Like when I started my career, there were quite a bit of a challenges where the programmer would say that I'm not a database guy. I don't know how to handle stress testing, load testing, and systems would not work as conveniently or as easily as they should be working. But with a full stack guy, the guy understands everything end to end and they are the ones who are architecting the whole system. So that way is there is a very convenient way of explaining things to the developer, getting things done and projects going live smoothly. So I work with lot many startups, many corporates and non-profits. What we have realized that when we go full stack on any particular project, the confidence level of an engineer is very high. The client is very conveniently executing the project with a team because the client knows that the developer gets it. So I guess that is a very big advantage because it gets a comfort level to the whole team. And that's why full stack is preferred by me now compared to any other specific niche kind of a technology. I believe everybody would completely agree that the future of full stack is really, really bright. But I would like to take this question in a different manner. Imagine right now if you are an engineer and you have a great idea, the next Facebook, the next Google or any next application that comes to your mind, what would happen? Earlier, you would have to figure out how would you build the backend, what will be the logic, how would the UI look, what would be the front end be like, how would the application be deployed, how it would be scaled, and a ton more questions. Now with full stack, as a developer or an engineer, you are able to handle the backend, the middleware, the frontend, everything end to end. So I think full stack will not just be popular, but full stack will be the only manner in which applications will be developed. Organizations now prefer full stack. Engineers now prefer full stack. And individually, the backend piece, the frontend piece, the middlewares, the APIs, the infrastructure, the DevOps, everything is now becoming easier day by day. So what has happened is that as an engineer, you are much more powerful, much more educated, and you can take the calls. So I think full stack will be completely popular, and it will be the only manner in which applications will be developed in the future. So the full stack development tools, as I said, are always smart and good. But the biggest problem as a full stack developer one needs to understand is a change in mindset. You are no more just a front-end guy or a back-end guy, or you are not just the guy who is doing the programming. You are a guy who is actually architecting, a guy or a girl who is architecting the whole system. So whenever we see full stack programmers, there are a few challenges that come in. First is the programming language challenge. In case if you are not very well versed with JavaScript, you would have to know the technology and tools really very well. Second is the mindset. You have to understand that you are not developing a piece, a module or a part of the system. The whole thing is very, very modular, but you have to have the end goal in your mind so that you understand how the whole system will be architected. So that is one of the challenges that I think a full stack guy has to understand. Apart from them, of course, slowly and steadily you will find that since full stack guys are developing the whole system end to end, there would be domain experts, there would be people who will understand the functionality of certain domains, certain industries very well, and then deploy things. So as a full stack guy, you have to, while you are starting writing the first line of the code, you have to also see that end of the day where it is getting deployed, how it is getting used, or how are the APIs getting consumed. So full stack development will also go to the extent where the same application is delivered on a mobile phone, on a desktop, on a website, even via an SMS or even an IoT device. So whenever you are a full stack developer, you have to kind of have the whole thing in the mind. So I think more than technology, it's first the mindset change that has to be taken care of. And of course, after that, all the tools and the new age tools which are there, most of them are open source. So you need to have a very strong understanding of how things work. You just can't say that I know how to code a piece of requirement. You need to know how the whole tech works in the background so that you can tweak, customize it to a level that it can really scale up. So these are the kind of challenges a developer needs to handle when they go full stack. Learning full stack development, in case if you are already a programmer, engineer, or you are developing something, it can be challenging because you have to really unlearn what you have learned. You have to undo how you were doing projects earlier and you have to reinitiate things. So that can be a challenge. But in case if you are starting afresh, new, or this is your first course that you are learning full stack on, I think it is a great opportunity. It is not at all difficult. The easy part is that you are learning less number of languages, tools, and technologies. So that is the easy part, because once you have a very good hold on JavaScript, your backend Node.js or your front-end Angular or React, your Meteor requirements, everything can be easily handled. So that is the good part. Of course, the challenging part is that you need to have a very strong understanding of how JavaScript as a language works. Initially, JavaScript was just used for some small animation, some validations here and there. Now, with the V8 engine, with Node.js and with new frameworks, people are really pushing JavaScript to the extreme. Now, in case if you just start doing it by your own, you might have success by making small modules, but you might not understand the basics, the foundation of how JavaScript works. So the challenge part is understanding technology, having a deep dive, understanding how it really, really works, and then deploying it. Of course, all of these are largely based on open source tools, and people keep iterating on them. So by the time you are working on React 15, React 16 is already there in the market. You are working on Angular 5, Angular 6, and 7 is there in the market. And there are tweaks and changes that happen. So you have to keep yourself updated. But before being updated, if your foundations are not very strong, you will not be able to shift very easily between these technologies. So the foundation part, of course, really important. Understanding open source in general is very important. And all of this can be made easy in case if you have a good guide or a mentor and you execute the whole project end to end. Like, you're not just making one simple page and proving yourself that, hey, I'm a full stack engineer. You are executing the project end to end. You take the idea and you really deploy the final solution on the cloud. And if you do that couple of times, then you would have a very strong understanding of how things really work. So now technology is easier, cheaper, faster. Tools are available, there are guides, mentors, and courses available, and you can learn fast, you can develop things easy, and you are just waiting for that next big idea to come, the next big job opportunity to come. Do not wait. Learn full stack, go deploy your first application, and really achieve what you really want to do. Full stack is very, very easy in case if you have the right mentors in place. Do the course, learn full stack, and prove yourself.